Hey, morning YouTubers, welcome to the channel. Sawmill Bill 70 here. I'm down here at the sawmill shed. I got four pillars, sonotubes put in yesterday. Now I still have some backfilling to do around them. They're secured, but I'll secure them more before I pour the concrete. But anyway, I'm giving you a different view here. Get tired of holding it, so I have the camera sitting on top of my Harbor Freight trencher on the roof. So, but anyway, weather beautiful. It's a little on the humid side, not bad. No wind, and there's not a cloud in the sky, and it's in the mid 60s. So for just about mid-July, I'm not going to complain. Anyway, what I want to do here today is I want to try to finish digging these footings for the sawmill shed. And I'll bring you along with 50 pieces of that. I don't know how long my SD curve's going to hold up. It's got quite a bit on it. And it could cut out at any time, and hopefully I catch it. Maybe we don't lose a lot, but anyway, I'll show you what I did yesterday, and then which I ended yesterday with, but I'll show you again just to remind you. So, let me get you on this. Okay. What we have here is the sonotubes are, that's the first one I put in. This is the second one. I don't know. That's 2 feet deep. They're 2 foot deep. You know, they're 4 foot sonotubes, and they're expensive, and I really don't want to use just one for, you know, one pillar. I can get two out of one, that I think I'm getting my money out of it. But anyway, I'm going to start over here, and this is the far corner, and shed's 32 foot long, so anyway, and these are spaced 8 foot apart, so that if I put girts in, if I do close it in, I'm not sure if I'm going to close it in yet or not, I don't know, but if I do, I can use 8 foot two bys as my girts. So, and the batter boards seem to be far enough away I can dig without. I'll be coming in here on an angle, on about a 45 degree angle, digging this one. But and then I'm going to have to go up to this one here. Okay, now this is going to be tougher to dig. This is actually virgin soil. I don't know what I'm going to get here. It's going to be tough to dig. And then over here, I've got, well, you can see the trencher set, well, no, right here it is, where the wheel is, that's 6 foot, and then I'll do the same up here at this end, they're 6 foot apart, the corner, and then in 6 foot, and that will leave me with a 20 foot opening, and I think that's going to be good enough for what I want to cut. If I get a 21 footer, what I'll have to do is just, you know, wiggle it in there, but anyway, I think 20 foot's enough, so I'll get back to you when I start digging.
Okay. I gotta get that bucket out of the way. It's in the way of the string. So, yeah. Anyway, I gotta string my lines again, and I gotta measure how deep I am. It's gotta be a minimum 2 foot. And, you know, if it's a little over, I'm not worried about it. That's fine. But anyway, I should be over 2 foot, that's for sure. So, I'll get back.